India became free on 15th August 1947. In 29th August 1947, a committee was formed. R. Ambedkar as the chairman, just to draft the constitution of the country. Until then, we were following the constitution of India, government of India, 1935, formed by the British campaign. The constitution of India was drafted in British Parliament. That time it was called the realm of Commonwealth countries. What is Commonwealth countries? Commonwealth countries means all the countries which were ruled by the British. Very simply, I used to tell the people, all those who played cricket were slaves. They were all ruled by the British. All the countries who played cricket, who waste time in cricket, are, it is a symbol of once we were slaves to the British. Yes. Other countries don't play the game. Japan, Germany, Switzerland, or any other good countries, they don't play the game. China, they are not prepared to waste time. Because we are very faithful to this game, because we want to show others that we were once slaves. Even now we are slaves to British. So in 29th August, the committee was formed. Then they prepared very well, and then they drafted. The draft was submitted on 4th November 1949, I should say, 1949, and it was accepted by the Indian Assembly, Constituent Assembly, in November 26th. Actually, even today, November 26th is observed as Indian Constitution Day. But we wanted to put it into effect from January 26, 1950, because January 26 was an important day. In 1930, Indian National Congress declared this day as Purna Swaraj. Purna Swaraj, that means complete freedom, completely free India. So, in order to remember that, in order to commemorate that, we made this day, 26th January 1950, as the Republic Day. So, the whole credit went to those big people, particularly to B.R. Ambedkar. And then, the history what they followed, everybody knows. Everybody knows. Now, we are on the 73rd Republic Day. Most of you might have born after 1950. What I say, 1947 August 15, we got freedom. No, before the Republic Day, Gandhiji was assassinated. Before the Republic Day, Gandhiji was assassinated. So in free India, there was really no freedom. Even British people mocked at us. We protected this great man for all these years, though he was against us. But you people just lost him. You could not save such a big leader. Yes, now to the present context. Though we celebrate, amidst this pandemic, people are celebrating the 73rd Republic Day. And there was some commotion, some dispute in the car procession in Delhi. And our Tamil Nadu car was denied. They selected only 12 states. Then people say there are 37 states, why don't you give all the 37 states some opportunity to participate? But that is nothing wrong. But what they say, some people said, referring to EOC, was he a merchant? No, popularity is different from integrity. All the actors and actresses were more popular than patriarchs and martyrs. No. Even I told my students, remember the birthday of Zubair associate with the Bethlehem on actor. Because they know the actors, they do not know the mortals. That does not mean that they are all less important. So he was he who floated the first ship, Indian ship, was not known to the North Indians. Was not known. But in fact he was guided by Balagangadhar Tilak. Balagangadhar Tilak was a very great leader. But these people say we do not know him. Just because you don't know him, he is not as important. That shows how stupid you are. Not only that, whenever a prime minister goes, you quote Subramanian Bharati. Even Subramanian Bharati was not known to him. When Subramanian Bharati used to meet Mahatma Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhi asked him, "Who are you?" "I am Subramanian Bharati, poet the great." He called himself, "I am the poet the great." Now, it is not self, it is not ego, it is self-respect. It is not pride, but it is confidence. So he said, "I am Subramanian Bharati, the poet the great." He says, "Actually, as I told you, you know, Rabindranath Tagore is known as poet the great, Mahakavi." And who called me Mahakavi? Mahatma Gandhiji called me Mahakavi. Who called Gandhiji Mahatma? Rabindranath Tagore called me Mahatma. They exchanged the titles. But what I say, Subramanian Bharati, he died very young. Most of the romantic poets, even in English, they died young. People like Keats, then all these people died young. But still they are alive. Subramanian Bharati, who was also a lover of Shelley, he is still alive because of his poems. Now, what I say, but people disown him. People disown him. And when he died, there were nearly 21, 22 people only to attend his funeral, Subramanian Bharati. You know why? He was excommunicated from his community. He was branded by birth. Just because he fostered a handicapped child in his house, he was excommunicated. And he used to wear a turban just to show that it is a symbol of masculine gender. And he used to grow a moustache. Brahmins don't have all these things. You know, even he is known as Nisan Kavinay. All these things he did because to show that he was a man. And such a revolutionary, such a wonderful poet and a national patriot are this world. No, actually, they are the losers. Subramanian Bharati is not the loser. And he was imprisoned and humiliated and ill-treated and tortured in the prison. What was the period of his imprisonment? 40 years. Of course, he was released a little earlier, but you know what? He was forced to pull the oil press. He was put on the floor with a rope. And whenever, you know, those people used to eat some poor, very untasty, unhealthy food in the jail. Once he said, "Could you please give me some rice?" Just because he asked rice, he was asked to fast for 4 days. They didn't give him even a cup of water. So he suffered like anything in there. He was a very famous advocate in Thoothukudi. When he was an advocate in Thoothukudi, he used to fight for the cause of the poor without getting single paise. Because he was rich by birth. But he sold all his property to buy a ship and lost everything because of the British. And you know that the Swadeshi movement he introduced, and he burnt all the foreign clothes. So this, we have one committee now, you know, to select the car in the Olympic Day Festival. They said, when they came to know that, how could he burn all the clothes? It is terrorism. That is terrorism according to this famous panel. So we cannot accept it. And again they are martyred, again they are assassinated, again they are killed. You know, people like Subramanya Bharati, Veera Nachiyar, Veeramani Gattamaman, Subramanya Siva, all these people just sacrifice their lives for the sake of you and I. At least, if you don't remember them, if you don't realize them, it's not the same. But when you dishonor them, it is a big offense. So let's all remember those patriarchs, those martyrs, and we should salute them in the right way. Similarly, like during the national festival, it should not be a custom or a ritual occasion to hoist the flag, take the pledge, and simply say something. No. Now, whenever we have this ceremony, I don't even call it a festival, a ceremony, not a celebration, we should take pledge to serve the nation as we are. We need not give up our lives. As we are, what are we? We are teachers. So do work to the best according to your conscience as teachers. Nobody can completely supervise you. Nobody can oversee you completely except God. So you must remember that God is the overseer. And we must do our duty, whether others supervise us or whether others control us or not. We should always be true to ourselves, and that is your contribution to the development of our country. So again, I thank all those people who have contributed to have the ceremony now in the right way, in the meaningful way. So instead of saying that Happy Republic Day, I should say that it must be a meaningful and a safety Republic Day. And again, I request all of you to remember that.